This next battle is scheduled for one fall. Introducing from parts unknown, weighing 271 pounds, Moondog Spot. And coming down the aisle, accompanied by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, His Eminence, the King.
Harley Race, the king of professional wrestling. Early on, we captured Bobby the Brain Heenan, and he said he's going to teach somebody some lessons.
Junkyard Dog, I'm going to teach you lesson number one in paying proper respect to the king. This is how you bow to the king. This is how you kneel to the king with your head up in the air. Junkyard Dog, lesson number one.
Easier said than done. Joining me here in the broadcast position, luscious Johnny B. I hope you learned a lesson this week, Johnny B. Wow. Just keep the managerial equipment on. You want to do a little broadcasting, all right, but I wouldn't advise you putting the tights on very often.
You know something, you kind of remind me of a judge that I had some trouble with down the road here not too long ago. I'll make my own decisions. I'm over 21 years of age, and I'm willing and able, pal. And I can still do whatever I gotta do. Don't worry about JB.
I'm sure. Johnny, let me ask you this. Let me ask your opinion on the choice of the site for WrestleMania 3, the Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan. How does that fare with some of the great facilities around the world?
Well, as we're watching the king here, Mr. Race, let me just say that I do agree with Pontiac because it's the most biggest and widely publicized spectacular in all of sports. That includes the Super Bowl. So why then, in fact, should we not let the fans come into a place where they can really pack them in, 90,000 strong? That's my opinion, all right?
Congratulations in hand, in store, I should say, for the managers of the Silverdome, being that they outbid everyone else in the entire world for location for WrestleMania.
What a move,
oh,
by
Ray.
What a move.
The cradle suplex by the king. Didn't take it very long to put away Moondog Spot. What a hole that is. And the king has got it down pat.
Here is your winner, the king.
Why doesn't a king get a crown that fits him, Johnny B?
Well, I would say that the man needs a little bit of a trimming up there, maybe in some of those golden locks. Maybe the thing would fit more secure. But then again, what do I know, according to you, right? So just shut up. Now I'm going to describe what's going to be happening here, baby. Here's the replay. Do you see Bobby the Brain Heenan? Madly attired.
Here it comes.
There you see. Spotty has missed with that knee. He went to go hit the man's dome right off. He has hurt his knee right now. Now you see King moving in for the kills. Front face lock. Hooks up. And you're going up, pal, whether you want to or not. And now you're coming down whether you want to or not. Because the force of relativity creates such the nimble move of one. And it's two and three for our Spanish-speaking network. Who knows, Trace? See you later, Grandma. And Cell Department, Long Island.